let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Nice run there. Brink picks up about 7 yards on the halfback draw. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
Makes it to the 35-yard line. Good run there.
Well, giving assist there to the offensive line, they gave him a good push up front.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 35. They'll bring him down at the 36-yard line. That's good for a game of 1 yard. That brings us second and 9. Rid of this one. And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Throws in the middle. Tackle right around the 42-yard line. 5, maybe 6 on that screen pass. That brings us 4th and 3. No, is back awaiting the punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Anderson's a guy you really have to game plan for if you're a defensive coach. And we sat down with the coaches this week, and they know, they look at him, they look at that offensive line, and they know they're in for a long day.
Well, it's going to be a tough challenge for this defense. One thing that they, I think, have to do is commit numbers to the line of scrimmage. They've got to be able to be willing to take chances, put an 8th, sometimes 9th guy up close to the line of scrimmage and force this quarterback to try to have to beat them by throwing the ball through the air. Otherwise, it could be a long day for this defense.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. That makes it 3rd and 3. Tight end right. Tight end right. Four down. Go. Tackle made at the 28. Ingram is back to receive. Heading for the corner. Ingram fields it at the 30, and he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. This one might be coming back, folks. So let's check out the penalty.
Receiving team.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. From their own 32-yard line, it's first down. Tackled at the 31.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established. And for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
Gets it. He's in space. And he's taken down the 39-yard line. they need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He makes his way to about the 48. From the 48-yard line, it's second down. And they'll run him again. Decent run here, right side. Meade awaits the snap. He punts. No, he won't. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Looks left, finding his tailback, and they make the stop around the 45-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Tackled for a loss.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
So at the end of one quarter, no score here. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Down he goes, around the 32-yard line.
It's a smart job here by the coaches, making a play call here that really played to their offensive strengths. That's knowing your personnel.
First and 10, ball on the 32-yard line. The sack.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
They come out on an empty backfield. He's going to try and scramble, and he can't get away from the pressure.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'd be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. steps out around the 37-yard line. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And it sails right on him. No good. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And he's tackled at about the 37-yard line. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 37. Quickly to the tight end. He's pushed out of bounds around the 30-yard line. That makes it first and 10. It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
It makes for an easy completion when you've got a guy who's that wide open. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A four-play, 64-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
I think the thing, Brad, that I'm seeing is the quarterback's taking advantage of some one-on-one opportunities on the outside for some big plays for this offense.
No, fields it at the one. They'll bring him down at the 14. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Runs right for a nice game. Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on the 18. There's a strike complete, and he's hit immediately. Brought down at the 41. A nice third down conversion there.
This offense has a tendency to run the football in this situation, as you can see, with good reason.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41. Anderson, again, he's taken down around the 43-yard line. The running back gets 2 on the carry.
Well, this corner isn't the biggest guy on the field, but he made a nice tackle there.
Strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down at about the 49. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Takes it in his tackled short.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break eventually could be the team that wins it.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Pulls it in and he's in the open field.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
From their own 33-yard line, first down. He's got it with room to run. And he is drilled at the 47-yard line. Around the 36-yard line.
That's the kind of play calling and execution I like to see. Being one-dimensional on first down can really stack the odds against you. It's better to mix it up.
Deep ball, laying it out there. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 36. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. Zips it to the tight end. Nice play to set up first and goal. Out of bounds, right around the 2-yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
They're at the 2. It's second down. They put everyone up on the line. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Anderson's performance for his team generally reflects how the team is going to play. And unfortunately for them right now, that's what they're seeing.
Brad, I just think they've gotten so accustomed to waiting to see how their star player plays that they've gotten used to just riding him all the way to the finish line. And here's a case where he's not necessarily playing his best game, and they're struggling. I think this is where you find out really what the team is made out of, because you need somebody else to step up and take some of the pressure off your star player.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. And he hits him hard at the 19.
That is a loss of 6 on that play.
We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 14-0.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnover. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. And they can forget about returning this one.
I tell you what, you got to give these guys credit. They put up a great defensive effort in the first half. They carry it over in the second half. Doesn't look like they're going to give in.
Yeah, and this game isn't over yet. I think it's going to require them to continue to play with this kind of edge and attitude to be able to give themselves a chance to win the game, because we still have a ball game in our hands and still a whole quarter to go.
Gets to about the 41-yard line.
That was a great call.
Yeah, here you see the draw play at its best. The tailback got good blocking up front and was able to pick up a bunch of yards.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. Run there, and a 6-yard pickup by the halfback on the delay.
That brings them second and five.
It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start, offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
He scrambled. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 44-yard line.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
First and 10, ball on the 44. They try him again, and this time they've got him in the backfield.
Scrambling, slides down. Jackson gains about 2 yards on the scramble.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 34. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Throws out, and a leaping interception by the corner.
It's a good play when the corner can break up a pass, but it's even better when he can bring it in for an interception.
Man left, man left. Going down, going down. That's 22, by 22. Set, round 50. Round 50. Cut on, cut on.
They go to the left for a nice game. Brink comes away with 5 yards on the carry. Second down and 5. Ball on the 32-yard line. And he's taken down around the 31-yard line. Around the 39-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Great pressure on the quarterback, forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
And they make the stop at the 39.
That brings us third and 10.
They'll line it up again on third down. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. And he's level at the 48-yard line. Meade is the punter. He punts. No, he won't. Tipped away. They don't pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands. I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
Giving the ball away can rattle your confidence, but he just needs to relax and not try to force it. He's starting off in great field position now.
And down he goes at about the 39-yard line.
That brings up second and down.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Fights forward to about the 36. So that scamper by the halfback is good for a first down.
You like how the offense is playing intelligent, controlled football here, using the safe run to get the first.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. It's second down now, 13 to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. He's on the run, and he's tackled around the 37-yard line.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
Here's the halfback on the screen. Brought down at about the 35. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kicks up. No good. He hooked it left. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. It's first down. Hands off to the left, and they wrestle him down behind the line. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 14. nothing. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Slings it. He's taken down right around midfield. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. And he's tackled right away.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Sacked on the play. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Booming kick. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
Well, this defense has got to be proud of what they've been able to do in this football game so far. Love to see the goose eggs up there for this defense. And the way their offense is playing, this game is really shaping together for this team.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Up the middle for a nice game.
Second and five.
We've got a second and five. Ball on the 25. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. They come out on an empty backfield. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Just under three to go in regulation. Now he's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked. It looked like they caught the quarterback by surprise.
Well, that's a great call by the defensive coordinator. They send him off the corner, and he just uses his speed to get the sack.
So the sack makes this a second and long. To him again, complete. Scruggs picks him up about 3 yards with the catch. There's a strike complete. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. And it's almost picked off. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Into the tailback, and he's met in the backfield. Loss of two by the halfback. From the 34-yard line. Second down. Just under two to go in the game. Conley gets the call. Gets to about the 34-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
And you've got the experience that this safety has. You can read plays very quickly and be in just the right position to make a stop near the line of scrimmage.
And he throws it away. Well, we've got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche? They call on the kicker for a long field goal. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he missed it left. No good.
Every time you have a chance to finish a drive with points, you've got to capitalize. That time, they couldn't come through.
They're ready to begin another drive.
Mike, four. Watch two. Watch two.
Tackle at the 47. One's incomplete. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. He gets hit out of bounds around the 38-yard line. That quickly. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line.
Hey, kill, kill, kill. Black five, black five. Check, check,
check. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 24-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Complete. He's got room. He's out of bounds at the 19. And that one goes for about 5 yards and first down.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
Just throws this one away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. Middle of the tight end. Tackle made at the 15-yard line.
Easy, easy.
Fumble! Recovered by the offense. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. A stop right there. Congratulations to that defense. That's going to be the ball game. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 18-yard line. Under a minute left. He'll go down to one knee. gets to about the 24-yard line. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, the Blue Jays, 14, the Longhorns, nothing. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.